So you're reading a recipe, and in the ingredients list, it says 1 cup of buttermilk. And then you're like, what the hell is buttermilk, and where do I get it? So buttermilk is something that does not exist outside of North America. So if you live in Asia or Europe or anywhere else in the world but North America, you're not gonna find buttermilk. It's just not a thing outside of America and Canada. Buttermilk used to be a byproduct of butter making. It is a liquid that's been separated from the butter fat after cream has been churned. That liquid that's left over, that is buttermilk. But nowadays in North America, buttermilk is a complete different thing. It is a fermented milk product, kind of like yogurt, and buttermilk is slightly thicker than milk. And it is usually low fat, so you get 1%, 2%, and I think sometimes you can find full fat buttermilk at the stores too, but usually I just see like 2% or 1%, they're more common. Buttermilk is used in a lot of American baked goods like chocolate cake, vanilla cake, waffles, biscuits, and buttermilk pancakes, which is one of my favorite things to make, by the way. It's also used in a lot of cookings, especially southern cooking. So you'll see buttermilk in cornbread and fried chicken and even salad dressing, like for example, ranch dressing. For baked goods, it's got the ability to tenderize gluten because it's got acid in it. And the acid in the buttermilk also reacts with the leavening agent that's inside the baked goods. For example, baking soda, it reacts with baking soda and it makes the rise even higher. So that's why baked goods that's made with buttermilk is so tender and fluffy, that's why. And it also keeps them moist. Another reason why buttermilk is good in baked goods is that because it's tangy, so it adds like a really nice tanginess and it creates multiple layers of flavors. It just gives it more dimension. And fried chicken that's made with buttermilk tends to be more tender because the acid that's in the buttermilk helps break down protein, therefore making the meat more tender. So what do you do if you can't buy buttermilk at the store? Well, you make it. Making buttermilk is super easy. You're gonna wanna start with some cultured yogurt or anything that has live culture in it will work. So besides yogurt, you can also use kefir, sour cream, or creme fraiche. So what I'm doing here is I'm just mixing 1 tablespoon of yogurt with about 1 cup of milk, and they're both full fat. Feel free to use low fat. And that's basically it. You're going to let this mixture ferment on your countertop without direct sunlight in a warm place covered with plastic wrap for 12 to 24 hours. And keep in mind that the longer it ferments, the more tangy it'll be. So adjust the time based on your preference. 12 hours later, this is what the mixture has become. It is kind of thick on the bottom, so what you want to do is just stir it up with a spoon and it'll become really smooth. And just like that, you made your own buttermilk at home. This is now ready to be used in your favorite pancake recipe. Okay, let's talk about buttermilk substitutes besides making your own. My favorite buttermilk substitute that I use all the time is combining equal part of yogurt and milk. And the pros of this are you can use it right away, you don't have to wait 12 to 24 hours, and it gives you the same effects and flavor of real buttermilk in baked goods. Another buttermilk substitute, you've probably seen this on a lot of YouTube channels or blog posts, is to combine 1 tablespoon of vinegar or lemon juice with 1 cup of milk. You basically just let it sit for 10 to 15 minutes until it curdles, and then magically it's like, hey, you made buttermilk. But here's the thing, it's not the same thing because it lacks that fermentation taste. It just doesn't taste like real buttermilk. So unless you're really, really, really in a pinch, don't ever go for this. So buttermilk will last in a fridge for at least 2 weeks. It'll last way longer than regular milk, but if you're making salad dressing with it, I suggest you use it up as soon as possible. You want to make sure that it's fresh.
fresh. But if you're baking with it, then it's totally fine. Like I said, it will last for a long time. And one way to tell that if it's gone bad is if it becomes a solid block and it's got this like weird looking pink mold on top. That's when you know that it's time to throw it out. If you've never tried baking or cooking or making pancakes with buttermilk before, I highly recommend it. It'll make everything taste so much better, especially baked goods. Really, it's just, I don't know, it's just different. So that's it for today's video. If you find today's video helpful, make sure you give us a like and subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you back in the kitchen next time.